Chapter 1, Introduction. Welcome to Volume 3 of the Municipal Inland Wetland Commissioners Training Program Series. I'm Larry Locus, and this is my digital assistant.
You mean the brains of the group.
In Volume 1, we introduced you to the Connecticut Inland Wetlands and Watercourses Act, your jurisdiction and responsibilities under this law. In Volume 2, you learned about the different maps and site plans that might be part of a wetland application. So what's there left to tell?
What do you think? What are the functions and values of wetlands and watercourses?
That's right. Wetlands and watercourses are one of the most biologically productive environments on Earth, rich in diversity and an essential part of our landscape. That's why the Connecticut Inland Wetlands and Watercourses Act acknowledges that these fragile natural resources are indispensable and irreplaceable. Inland wetlands and watercourses are an integral part of the web of nature, essential to hydrologic stability, as well as the existence of many forms of animal, aquatic, and plant life. I urge you to take a moment and read the full text of the law.
It can be found on the State of Connecticut website, ct.gov.
Now, in this program, we'll divide the functions and values of wetlands and watercourses into two very broad areas. First, those associated with hydrology, such as water quantity and water quality. Second, those associated with ecology and the support of plants, wildlife, and aquatic life. Then in the final chapter called Land Use, we'll discuss how proper management decisions can maintain or even enhance these functions and values. But what do we mean by functions and values? Well, there's no hard and fast line between the two. Check this out.
The term wetland functions and values is sort of a compound phrase that makes a lot of sense together and is a lot harder to tease apart the various pieces. Well, what is a function and what is a value?
The functions of these wetlands really create their values.
Water quality and water quantity.
The hydrology, how water moves over and through the landscape.
The ability to mitigate stormwater.
Water filtration and sediment retention.
Provide pollutant renovations.
Aquifer recharge, so underground water recharge.
Clean drinking water.
Wetlands are a large storehouse for carbon.
How they contribute to the nutrient cycling in forests and our ecosystems.
Great habitat for diversity of Connecticut's wildlife species.
Habitat for aquatic organisms.
Incubating fisheries.
People fish in wetlands, go kayaking.
People will hunt in wetlands or cut trees in wetlands.
Education. The uniqueness of the plants.
There's a big industry in wildlife viewing in Connecticut.
I might say that flood control is an important function of wetlands.
Fur bearer trapping.
Recreation.
No. Flood control is a value.
Wildlife photography.
We value wetlands because they control floods. The function is water storage.
Cultural significance of wetlands.
No, it's not that flood control is the value, it's the protection of property.
Beauty and aesthetics.
So we could go on and on and on arguing about these things. But the key is that they operate well together. We value wetlands because of what they do for us. And we have to pay close attention to the way they function if we want to maintain those values.
See the problem? It's not so cut and dried. One person's function may be another person's value.
I think you better start at the beginning.
Good idea.